I deal with computer centric stuff. So I researched from grade 9 up until grade 12, where I was looking at the salaries and I was happy with the salaries that they were showing on the website. There was this career SA where I used to look, and then I used to see for like which companies can one work for, and then Telkom was like the one that I wanted to work for, you know, the buzzers, which companies are offering, and then what kind of things can you do after that. At first, I discovered things like desktop administrator, network administrator, application developer. I didn't come across the word computer science. And then when I came the word, when I encountered the word computer science, I discovered that it is the base of computing. You know, when you are doing computer science, it means you can then later choose any field that you want to focus on, be it security, be it network, be it development, be it artificial intelligence, be it computation, numerical computation and stuff. So I researched more on where can I, because the network administration, the application development, get them mostly in colleges. So I came to Nivo and then I found that, okay, computer science. I knew that I'm coming to computer science, but then when I got here, it was, you choose with another that you choose. So I didn't know that. I thought that I was only coming here for one year. And then I had to choose. I had to choose electronics. So I specialized in electronics and computer science. Meaning, so the advantage is then is that when you finish your degree, you can either choose to specialize or take the electronics route or computer science. Then, because I always wanted to. I did my honors and masters in computer science, right? And then that's the things that we need to do currently. If you are talking about one industrial revolution, it means you have to have multiple skills. You cannot be having only one skill, because now you are going to be costing companies money, you know? So when I was in my third year, like I said, that's the year that I got my test. I was not good, but it's not like I was getting 19. I was just an average student. And then I started being an SI when I was in my second year, first semester, up until I was doing my honors. Like, I was already studying other students in SI study. So, yeah. When I was in my third year, I got my first intern. That's why I'm surprised. Interns are not after you, and you don't know what you're doing. But then that interview, I unfortunately have been because I was writing my exams. And then I went to an interview in Microsoft in 2016. You can imagine me. You see, I met Lupin in that's when I started growing more, being exposed to the outside world. Because what he came to us was the mindset that, hey, you cannot be having a mindset of a student when you are being there. You have to have a mindset of the outside world. What do you want to do? Expose yourself. Learn how to communicate, present and stuff. So this interview, I went to Microsoft. And then there's two interviews. The first one is a practical interview. That's what I'm asking. Yes. Are you guys developing your skills? Mm-hmm. When you go there, you have to show them what you can do. It's all about showing them that you can do the job in order for you to get the job. The main thing is show us what you can do. If you cannot show us what you can do, then there's no job for you. Understand? Then the second interview is where that you finalize things and then you can do the HR things and then the people are working. They will know when you are going to start. And that's what I went through. They wanted me to come to Microsoft when I was doing my honors. But I couldn't because I was full-time student, which was attending classes. Then I had to say, hey, I want to be able to come to Microsoft.
You will be supported.
Yeah. I feel there's a lot of people like, hey, man, how can you reject the interview? How can you reject the job? Like, in the
Microsoft.
But anyway, I am not a fan of Microsoft. I hate Microsoft technology. The guy who likes Microsoft this year. For me, I'm a Linux guy. And then all the open source technologies.
I like Windows
now. I don't
know.
I wanted to advise you guys on how to. I had my CV when I was in my head, you know, a very good CV that I'm still using now. I've been updated since maybe like a year ago. When I was there, it was then when I was updated. So 2 years with updated, but then it was a very good CV that I used. It's not good for me, it's good. According to me, it's good because I do things that add up on my CV. Like, I know that when I see a course, then I can listen for the course, I attend the course. I know that I will, it's a skill that we get from the course, then I will add up on my CV. But I volunteer, I become part of things, you know, and then you always add those things in your CV. And then that's why I was saying, like, it's good that you, if you give them projects to do, alone, they will learn more. So you put projects on your, the project that you do on in your studies, you can put them in your CV. You know, this year objective is what I was asking you guys, what do you want to do next year? I'm going to ask you in 5 years, where do you want to see yourself? That's going to be more time for you to answer. And I wrote this when I was in my thing. You see, these are the projects that I did. They are not much, but then you put them and then you outline what you did, and then you go after this. You mention the skills that you learn from each project that you do. Understand? Then here is the in like. Involve yourself in leadership roles and then things that will enhance your skills. When I joined MIH, it was when I got exposed to saying you have to be involved. If you are not involved, if you are not helping your community, you are going to suffer later on. You know, because, I mean, that's how you get. If you are not a leader in your field, it becomes hard for you to move. So these are the things that I did, and then you can see these are the achievements that I have, like from high school through the university, and then currently. And then put your information. Wow, information about yourself at the end. Why? Because you see how. That CV is attractive, according to me. You have your objective, you have your current studies that you are doing, you have all your qualifications, all your skills that you do. And then when a person is going through your CV, he or she can see that, wow, this person is good, I understand. Up until they get at the end, and they find that he's from African campus. You know, he's not from Bosch, he's not from there. But then his CV was good, understand? Then it's a matter of being at a position. What can we do now with this person? So you see, it comes hard for them to let go. And then if they are looking maybe for a female, and then they see that this guy is a male, but he has met all the requirements and maybe exceeded them. So it gives you an advantage. Yeah, this is my last slide before questions. So you can imagine how you guys know how to cook. Ladies and gentlemen. You don't know. let me say something very quickly. Programming is vital. You cannot just program if you are in ICT. Like, you think you will have a manager next year, but you don't have managerial skills, you don't have, you are doing IELTS, where you are being taught how to program, how to play software, how to do it. What we do here is more on that. Same for course they do, will be the engineering, they will also learn hardware. Like, you guys understand. And the entry job as a graduate, it's majorities program you are going to have to do the actual work. Unless if you are a consultant, then you are gonna be interacting with clients and then not doing what you were studying in college. Because the thing is, varsity will pay a lot of money. So don't waste that money on when you have to be now go to level and you change things, you do things that you didn't go to school for. You understand? I mean, you cannot become a network engineer after. You will have to, if you are to become a network engineer, you will have to go through a lot of training. Because networks, it mostly involves, you have to have a lot of experience when you are doing networks. Yeah, very right. With code, you can make mistakes, you will bring that in. So for me, I like coding very much. I'm always trying to learn new techniques and other things, so I said. But then, because it is actually the entry point. You are in research, you will find yourself even writing some code. You are into a job, you find yourself writing some code. So don't say, programming or not. If you want to get into industry, that's what you are going to start with. I mean, my two colleagues are working now. They are programming, isn't it? You see. So make sure that you go back. You are being taught programming. That skill is, it's the most valuable skill. You can change the world with code. So make sure you go back and then you guys, you have to take it away. Emphasize on learning that skill, especially if you want a job. You ladies, advantage is that they are always looking for you because the shortage of women in ICT industry. You know, I have female friends. I'm always advising them to say, hey, that is the interview. It's easy. I have other colleagues who works at and she said she deals with me. And then I was like, okay, she deals with it. And then I asked her what kind of things is she doing, and she was saying that they analyze, they manage. And I said, okay, you can get yourself ahead. Go to Coursera and then start learning this thing, machine learning. And then you will know how to use data in a very fascinating way. You know, she did computer science at this. I know she's familiar with She's busy with it, and I'm waiting for her to complete, and then she will be very busy. So, ladies, we need you in industry. And then there's a lot of opportunities for you guys. More than us. Like, I mean, if a lady should be paid enough, she can go to it, and then she will have opportunities. You see? So, that was my last week. I think I'm going to present the one there. Can I present for honors students, those who want to do honors, masters, PhD? You guys allow me. I have a presentation based on this. I believe something. And then I will have a store so that you can come and ask me about this one. If you are interested in doing honors, PhD, and masters. Right. Yeah, especially ladies. Let's do questions.
I was asking what if you were interested but not now? Do you still have an interest?
Yeah. Questions, guys, based on the presentation.
but we did our best. I can tell you this thing, man. You can't hear me. You see, man, I'm not talking like my age yet. Look.
How's it better? Say, no, I am in now, I am safe.
you can see it like that. You see, you still need your degree, you still need to study, but again, on the other side, you still need to keep yourself. Because you will find that you don't have managerial skill, okay? And then the channel that you need to go through is for you to have that skill. And then your degree didn't give you that. But the other sources that can be able to give you that skill for you to reach where you want to go. So you still need both.
One more answer. Yes, you studied, and the guy who didn't go to study also studied. He's still studying. The fact he put time and effort to go to university and learn that thing, that study. For you to go to school and study, that study. So there's no excuse. Without a degree, as a company, they say that you must have evidence of the projects you have done. So it's the same thing. So both of them work. So there's no way out.
And you should not also lose context. We are in South Africa.
Yes.
In South Africa, they want a degree.
Yeah.
In America, you can. In Canada, you can.
In South Africa, we're not playing in terms of ICT. Google is Google.
We are talking about game. We are saying we should advise you what to do.
Not exactly. Take Facebook South Africa. Okay. Last year we can move the vision of Facebook to South Africa. The entry point for a lot of people to enter into Facebook said A. It was a degree. But when you go outside, it's not a degree. See that? Because remember, when you take the US education, they believe too much in technical universities or colleges. Unlike here, we believe much in universities. See that? So that is where the distinction is. When they moved Facebook ZA this side, it was a matter of they needed entry for the degree. But the other side, it is not like that.
Cool. Yeah.